Very warmest of welcomes to all of you to the 2021 New South Wales Premier's Literary Awards. My name is John Vallance, and I'm speaking to you from the Shakespeare Room at the State Library of New South Wales. We're going to begin this evening by hearing from Yvonne Weldon, who's the chair of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council and an established writer in her own capacity. In 2016, she was shortlisted for a significant literary award in Queensland, and in 2017, won the Allen and Unwin Faber Literary Academy Scholarship. Yvonne Weldon.
Hello, Premier, ladies, gentlemen, sisters and brothers. My name is Yvonne Weldon. I am a Wiradjuri woman from Cowra, here in New South Wales. I'm from the waters of the Clare, which is also known as the Lachlan, and of the Murrumbidgee Rivers. I am the elected chairperson of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, who are the culture authority under the Aboriginal Land Rights Act for the land that I am on. I'd like to pay my respects to all elders past and present, to all First Nations and to you and the many nations lands that you are on today. Welcome to country is an age-old tradition. It is more than just words, it is a spiritual process by honouring the ancestors' footsteps we are walking in. Continuing the practice of the generations before us to the many generations to come. The landscapes of this country tells us stories of our culture, our history, and our boundaries. The Eora Nation's country's boundaries are the Hawkesbury in the north, the Nepean in the west, and the Georges River in the south. On behalf of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, the elders, and the members, I welcome everyone to the land of the Gadigal. I acknowledge the Gadigal people and the traditional owners' lands that you are on today, whose spirits and ancestors will always remain with this land, our Mother Earth. Our practices have sustained us throughout the generations, and they are ingrained into the core of this country, working together as one community and achieving as one community. Through the hundreds of nations, tribes and clans that have existed here for over 60,000 years, my people are the oldest living culture of the world. So let us reflect on the many stories and truths of this ancient earth, the ones from the First Nations and also from the nations that have joined us here, creating our joined history into the greatest book to be read. The creativity and the truth of written word enriches our lives to be shared and connected, creating that connection of my people, your people, and our people together. All of us can make a positive change to each other now and into the future. To make that future possible, let us all draw upon my people's spirits as we continue on our journey. May my people's spirits walk with you and guide you as we strive forward for us all. Again, on behalf of the Metropolitan Local Aboriginal Land Council, welcome to Gadigal land. This always was, always will be Aboriginal land. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Yvonne. And I also acknowledge that I'm standing this evening on Gadigal land, and I pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. In fact, we're very excited at the work we're doing with emerging Aboriginal leaders at the library at the moment. And if you have the opportunity, I hope you'll come and have a look at the exhibitions that we're currently preparing. And in particular, a very exciting exhibition about Dyarrabin, the Hawkesbury area to the north of Sydney. There is a rather lovely line in a fragment of a work that's otherwise lost by the ancient philosopher Aristotle. And it goes like this. The more time I spend on my own, the more I like stories. And if there's ever been a year in our history where we've spent a lot of time on our own, I think it's been this last one. So it's hard to imagine a better time to be holding a literary awards ceremony, although you could say, one could say that any year, but this really has been a year of solitary enjoyment of reading and writing for many of us. The New South Wales Premier's Literary Awards, established in 1979, are arguably, and I'd certainly argue that, the most significant awards supporting writing and also publishing in Australia at the moment. And the State Library of New South Wales is very proud to be involved with supporting such an important series of awards. I'm very pleased now to hand over to my friend and colleague, the President of the Library Council of New South Wales, the Honourable George Souris.
Good evening and welcome to the Premier's Literary Awards 2021. Thank you for joining us on this occasion. I want to thank the Premier and the Minister for being with us this evening and to particularly thank the government for the way it has supported the State Library this year and helped us with our redevelopment, and as well the Public Library Network of New South Wales. Premier and Minister, you have been with us for these awards every year, and it's a pleasure once again to see you here. My great pleasure now is to introduce the Minister for the Arts, Don Harwin. And Don, thank you for being here. Thank you also for the support you have given the State Library over many years. You're regarded as a friend of the Library, and I have great pleasure now in introducing you to speak to us.
Since 1979, the New South Wales Premier's Literary Awards have provided an opportunity to highlight the importance of literature to our state and to our cultural life as a nation. Congratulations to all the nominees and winners. We know that writing takes time and immense dedication, and these awards play an important part in recognising your commitment to the craft. Over the past year, we know how much COVID-19 has dramatically impacted on the creative industries, and literature is no exception. That's why the New South Wales government made the single largest one-off investment in the literature sector, with more than $2 million invested through the Rescue and Restart Fund this year. Just over $1.2 million was provided in direct stimulus to writing organisations and writing festivals, and $865,000 was provided in strategic initiatives to support regional residencies and activities throughout regional New South Wales. The State Library of New South Wales continues to use its platform to celebrate writing, writers, and publishers. And the Premier's Literature Awards recognise many different genres, from poetry to biography to playwriting. We're so lucky to attract such a high calibre of work from such diverse voices. Awards like these have never been more important. Happily this year, we're able to announce the winners on the eve of the Sydney Writers Festival, which will once again shine a light on our great local writers. And now it's with great pleasure that I introduce to you the Premier of New South Wales, the Honourable Gladys Berejiklian.
I always regard the Premier's Literary Awards as a very special time of the year and a special time to acknowledge all of our writers, the critics, and the public that have a passion for reading, as do I. Because of COVID, I'm providing this video message, but hope to join all of you very soon to celebrate the great writings that our state has to offer. Especially during these difficult times, writers dig deep to find issues and themes which educate us, entertain us, inform us, and also cause us to reflect. And I'm deeply grateful to all of you for producing these wonderful works. Grateful to all who are organising the judging, which I've told this year is more difficult than ever. And also to your support networks, your families and friends that keep you going during those difficult times when you're isolated and writing and creating these wonderful pieces of art. Congratulations, thank you, not just to the award recipients, but to all whose work has been acknowledged. Can I encourage you to continue to inspire? And I look forward to joining with you on a future occasion.
Thank you very much, Premier. Thank you, Minister. And thank you both for providing us with those messages. A year ago, when I was hosting these awards at the library, I spoke to you from an empty Mitchell Library reading room. The library closed to the public on the 23rd of March. It was the first lengthy closure of the library for nearly 100 years. And I'm now recording this a little over a year after that closure. We're still on the way to reopening, but we're not quite there yet. Back in December and January, I'd rather hope that we'd be doing this event in person, but that was not to be. But Minister, Premier, thank you very much for taking the time to provide us with those recorded messages. I'd also like to thank the senior judge of the awards this year, Jane McCready, and her 29 fellow judges. I said something about a particular interest in writing and reading in the year of the plague, and this year the awards attracted 633 entries. So Jane McCready and her team of judges had a pretty huge task on their hands. So thank you to everyone involved in making these awards what they are. All right, well, let's get started now. The first award this evening is the Multicultural New South Wales Award, sponsored by our colleagues at Multicultural New South Wales. The award's valued at $20,000 and covers all genres of writing, including fiction, non-fiction, memoir, history, poetry, playwriting, and script writing. The works under consideration must display a high degree of literary merit and, in addition, must address the Australian migration experience and aspects of cultural diversity and multiculturalism in our society. This year, the judges were Osman Faruqi, Moore Blessing Machiruri, and Randa Abdel Fattah. And the shortlist for 2021 is After Australia, edited by Michael Muhammad Ahmad, Affirm Press. The F Team by Rawa Arja, Giramondo Publishing. Metal Fish Falling Snow by Kath Moore, Text Publishing. The Coconut Children by Vivian Pham, Penguin Random House Australia. A Lonely Girl is a Dangerous Thing by Jessie Tu, Alan and Unwin. And Throat by Ellen van Nieuwen, University of Queensland Press. And I'm very pleased to introduce Joseph Laposta, who runs Multicultural New South Wales, to announce the winner.
Thanks, Dr. John, and can I also thank you and the entire team at the State Library for the incredible work that you do to make sure that all of our material and literature is circulated and shared right across our community throughout New South Wales, but especially some of our more vulnerable and hard-to-reach communities, including some of our new and emerging communities. It's a great gift that you and the team provide. I'm here on behalf of the Minister for Multiculturalism to announce the winner of the State Library Multicultural Award. Can I just say before I announce the winner that you are in esteemed company. Some of the past winners include Tim Sopomasan, the former Race Discrimination Commissioner, Michael Muhammad, Maxine Beniba-Clark, and of course, Peter Pilates last year. And this year's winner for 2021 is Alan van Nieuwen for Throat. Alan, on behalf of all of us, a big congratulations.
Thank you very much to the awards and the judges. At my acknowledgement of the other shortlisted titles and their authors, for me, this book has been more than just a book. It's been an opportunity to write alongside my mum in particular, who's been a big supporter of this book, and other family members. It's a book that I've got so much amazing feedback from readers. I've had people come up to me and tell me that this is the first poetry book that they've engaged with, which is amazing, or that my book has sparked a story in them. So really it's quite a collective work, and to have my work received by the judges in this form is very humbling. So many thanks.
We now move to the biennial New South Wales Premier's Translation Prize, which is also sponsored by Multicultural New South Wales and which is valued at $30,000. This year, the guidelines have changed, and the award is now given for a translation by an Australian citizen or permanent resident that's been published within the last 2 years. The judges this year were Beth Yarp, Mario Licon Cabrera, and Josh Stenberg. And the shortlisted translations are This Tilting World by Colette Fellou, translated by Sophie Rebecca Lewis, published by Two Lines Press and Les Fugitives, Travels with a Writing Brush, Classical Japanese Travel Writing from the Manyoshu to Basho, translated by Meredith McKinney, Penguin Random House Publishing. Autumn Manuscripts by Tassos Levatidis, translated by Nick Trakakis, Smokestack Books. Sergius Seeks Bacchus by Norman Erickson Pasaribu, translated by Tiffany Tsao, Giramondo Publishing. Imminence by Mariana Dimopolo, translated by Alice Whitmore, Giramondo Publishing. Russia Washed in Blood, a novel in fragments, by Artyom Vesioli, translated by Kevin Windle, Anthem Press. And once again, I hand over to Joseph LaPosta to announce the winner of the translation prize.
As I'm sure many of you in the room know, we speak over 220 different languages in New South Wales. We are one of the most linguistically diverse states on earth, and our translators play a critical role in helping break down barriers and disseminate information. A great example of that is throughout the COVID pandemic, where we translated into over 53 different languages and over 1,600 documents right throughout the government messaging throughout those 12 months. In this context, we are absolutely delighted to recognise through the State Library two winners for the Translation Award. And those two winners are Nick Trikakis and Alice Whitmore. Nick and Alice, a massive congratulations and well done.
It's such an enormous honour to be chosen as one of the joint winners of this year's New South Wales Premier's Translation Prize. I'm very grateful to the State Library of New South Wales for supporting the work of translators in this way, and for recognising the role of translation in the Australian literary ecosystem. Of course, I'm very grateful also to Ivar at Giramondo for introducing me to Mariana's work many years ago, and for all of the work that he always puts in behind the scenes. To Nick at Giramondo for editing the book and for being an amazing editor. To Leia, who did all of the publicity for the book. And of course to Mariana for being a genius, for being an amazing friend and ally throughout the translation process and beyond. I wish her all the very best in her future literary endeavours, which are no doubt going to be very exciting. And I hope I get to be involved in those. Thanks again and have a lovely evening.
I thank the judges for this great honour, which I hope will give the work of Duchess Libavidis the recognition it deserves. I would also like to acknowledge a few others who have helped make this venture a reality. Andy Croft, my publisher from Smokestack Books. Stelios Halas, Duchess Libavidis' beloved grandson. And Constantina Giorganda for her steadfast support and expertise. I will end with the final lines of a poem called Pages of the Calendar, an exemplary Libavidis poem. Lord, you have treated poets unjustly by giving them only one world. And when I die, I want to be buried in a pile of calendar pages so that I might take time with me. And perhaps whatever of us remains will lie by the edge of our path, a small forget-me-not.
And now we move to the $30,000 Nick Enright Prize for Playwriting. The judges this year were Susie Miller, Joanne Key, and David Berthold. And the shortlisted plays are Triple X by Glace Chase, Queensland Theatre and Sydney Theatre Company. Lady Tabuli by James Alazzi, National Theatre of Parramatta. No Pay, No Way by Marika Hardy, Sydney Theatre Company. The Visitors by Jane Harrison, Mughalin. Packer and Sons by Tommy Murphy, Belvoir. Milk by Dylan Vandenberg, The Street Theatre. And the winner is Dylan Vandenberg for Milk.
Hello. This is an incredible honour, even to be included on a shortlist with such vital plays and talented writers is pretty astounding, but to win, I am delighted. Sincere thanks to the State Government of New South Wales, the State Library of New South Wales, and the judges of the Nick Enright Prize for Playwriting. Plays don't come about in a vacuum, and there are many people whose thoughts, ideas, and encouragement I need to recognise. Firstly, the Street Theatre in Canberra, and especially Caroline Stacey for championing this work right from the beginning. Peter Matheson, David Atfield, and Jin Savage for their dramaturgical wisdom. The Mob, who've helped develop this play over the last few years, and in particular, Arnie Gay Doolin for her guidance. To Mum and Steve, Dad and Ash and Annie. To my partner, Emily, you shoulder so much that I can do this, and I love you very much. And lastly, to my little girl, Charlotte, I wrote this play for you, and you'll know where we come from and who you come from and understand the resilience and strength that lives on in you. I think that theatre is a powerful platform that will help us edge towards reconciliation, because on our stages, collaboration is not just necessary, but vital. It will help us all understand, heal and grow.
And now the Betty Rowland Prize for Playwriting, which is worth $30,000. The judges this year were Anna Brunowski, Craig Batty, Reg Cribb, and their three shortlisted works. Freeman by Laurence Billier, General Strike and Matchbox Pictures. Penguin Bloom by Sean Colin Grant and Harry Cripps, Made Up Stories. Stateless, Episode 6, The Seventh Circle, by Elise McCready, Matchbox Pictures. And the winner is Freeman by Laurence Billier.
Thank you. How exciting. Writing is difficult at best of times, but writing in a language other than your own is next level. So as a non-native English speaker, I'm very, very proud to have won the Betty Rowland Award for Best Script Writing. And I'm grateful to the New South Wales Premier, her team, the jury, and the other two nominees. I'm very, very honoured to be listed alongside you. I wouldn't say that the film wrote itself, but it was made much easier by Cathy Freeman's extraordinary contribution. Her words were a complete inspiration and guided me through the writing of this film. I'd like to thank Cho Chichester and Kath Earle at the ABC, as well as Helen Pankhurst at Matchbox Pictures, who believed in this project from the word go and made it happen. A big thank you also to Stephen Page, my co-director extraordinaire, and his fabulous team at Bangarra Dance Theatre, who sprinkled a bit of their magic on the film. We made our Freeman during the Melbourne lockdown, or should I say the Melbourne lockdowns, so I'm very thankful to my family, Rachel and Emil. I know everything I owe you. And to the small production team who rallied behind it, including Joni Z, Kathleen Pagzak, and Daniel Wickman. In those dark, grim Melbourne days, it was an absolute joy working with you. Needless to say, it's been an absolute honour and privilege to be involved in telling such a precious story. I'm forever grateful to Cathy Freeman for her trust. Her words were an inspiration, and the film wound up being a love letter to the kind of person she is and the kind of people we could be. For 49 seconds back in 2000, Black and White Australia stood together as equal. I hope this film will continue to inspire us all to fight hard so this becomes a permanent reality. Thank you.
And now to the prize for younger readers, the $30,000 Patricia Wrightson Prize for Children's Literature. Judges this year were Elisa Darlison, Bronwyn Bancroft, and Dub Leffler. And the shortlisted books for the Patricia Wrightson Prize for Children's Literature this year are Action Tank, Book 2 by Mike Barry. Mike Barry was here. Winter of the White Bear by Martin Ed Chatterton, Dirt Lane Press. Across the Risen Sea by Bryn McDibble, Allen and Unwin. I Heart the World, a celebration of land, sea, flora, fauna, and people around the globe by Tanya McCartney, Hardy Grant Publishing. The Grandest Bookshop in the World by Amelia Meller, Affirm Press. Her Perilous Mansion by Sean Williams, Allen and Unwin. Amelia Meller is the winner for The Grandest Bookshop in the World, published by Affirm Press.
Oh my goodness, what a glorious honour this is. I'm absolutely ecstatic and deeply appreciative that you've chosen The Grandest Bookshop in the World as the winner of the Patricia Wrightson Prize for Children's Literature. I've wanted to be a writer since I was a toddler, but I never dared to dream that so many people would love this book. It's so heartwarming to be supported and celebrated like this for my interpretation of the Cole family's fascinating place in Australian history. Winning such a prestigious award for a debut novel blows me away. State libraries have been so important throughout our history and throughout the creation of my book. They opened the brilliant mind of Mr. Cole in their earliest days. Not only that, but the state libraries of Victoria, South Australia, and New South Wales also gave me access to a huge wealth of historical sources and knowledge, both physically and through their databases. I was a broke student when I started writing this book, and without free access to these resources, it might never have existed. So thank you, State Library of New South Wales. It's simply amazing to be recognised by you and the Premier through this prize. Of course, I wouldn't be here without my marvellous publisher, Affirm Press, my inspiring family and friends, my earliest barrackers, the May Gibbs Trust, or the thousands of young readers across Australia. Congratulations to everyone winning awards tonight, and congratulations to all the shortlisted writers. It's so delightful to see such passion for Australian literature.
And now the Ethel Turner Prize for Young People's Literature, which is worth $30,000. Judges this year were Felicity Castagna, Sarah Ayoub, and Erin Goff. And the shortlist is The F Team by Rawa Aja, Girmondo Publishing. The End of the World is Bigger Than Love by Davina Bell, Text Publishing. Ghost Bird by Lisa Fuller, University of Queensland Press. Metal Fish Falling Snow by Kath Moore, Text Publishing. Where We Begin by Christy Neiman, Pan Macmillan Australia. Lona by Georgina Young, Text Publishing. And the winner is Davina Bell for The End of the World is Bigger Than Love, published by Text.
Hello, my name's Davina Bell, and I'm speaking to you from the Wurundjeri land of the Kulin Nation on country that has never been ceded. And I pay my respect to elders past, present, and emerging. Well, thank you so much for awarding my book, the Ethel Turner Prize for Children's Literature. I am honoured and humbled and genuinely shocked. And to the judges who selected the book as the winner, thank you so much. This book took 8 years and a lot of self-doubt to write, and your recognition means the world, so thank you. To the State Library of New South Wales, thank you for facilitating the award. And to the Department of Premier and Cabinet, thank you for your generous support. And I hope that government across all levels in Australia continues to support the publishing industry, particularly the children's publishing industry, given the really strong links between childhood reading and future life success. It is my hope that every writer has the gift of working with an editor who is as clever and sensitive and insightful and funny as Elena Gagoulis from Text Publishing. Thank you so much, Elena, for the chance to work with you, for your faith in this manuscript right from the start, and for helping me turn it into something that I could be proud of. And to the whole crew at Text, to Michael and Kate and Steph and Maddie and Imogen and the whole gang, thank you for your hard work in bringing this book to the world. And I'm so in awe of the courage and intelligence of your publishing always, and I'm proud to call myself a Text author. To my agent, Pippa Masson, thank you for your support and for championing me over many writing seasons. And to all my colleagues and friends who had to put up with me complaining about how hard it was to write this book over 8 years, I hope you know how much I cherish and appreciate you all. If by some miracle my dad has figured out how to use the internet and is watching this tonight, thank you, John Bell, for all the times you took me to the library and the bookshop as a kid. I wouldn't be here without you. I would like to dedicate this award to the memory of my mother. She would have really loved to brag about this. And congratulations to the other shortlisted authors. Thank you once again.
The Kenneth Slesser Prize for Poetry is also worth $30,000. The judges this year are Lachlan Brown, Eunice Andrada, Enrico Craig, and the shortlisted books are Element, The Atomic Weight and Radius of Love by Geordie Alberston, Puncher and Wattman, Ask Me About the Future by Rebecca Jessen, University of Queensland Press. A History of What I'll Become by Jill Jones, University of Western Australia Publishing. Change Machine by Jaya Savage, University of Queensland Press. Throat by Ellen Van Nierven, University of Queensland Press. And the winner for the second time this evening is Ellen Van Nierven for Throat.
Thank you for this great honour, which I'm accepting in my home on Yuggera and Turrbal country. I would like to say thank you to the judges and to the awards. I would like to acknowledge the other shortlisted poets on your shortlisting. I would like to pay special thanks to my mum and dad and other family members, as well as my friends, and two mentors in particular, Sue Abbey and Janine Lane. I would like to thank my publisher and my editor, and for everyone who came behind this work while it was being made. Thank you.
The Douglas Stewart Prize for Nonfiction is valued at $40,000. This prize receives well over 100 entries each year, and as a result, there are five people on the judging panel for the Douglas Stewart Prize. This year, they were Katrina Menzies-Pike, Sheila Nhok Pham, Richard White, Tamsin Peach, and Jay Ching Hoon Park. And their shortlist for this year includes Father of the Lost Boys by Yot Ajang Alak, Fremantle Press. In the Time of the Manaroans by Miro Bilbro, Victoria University Press. Woomera Lane, Lives and Landscapes by Tom Carmont, Giramondo Publishing. The Warrior, The Voyager and the Artist, Three Lives in an Age of Empire by Kate Fulliger, Yale University Press. A Question of Colour, My Journey to Belonging by Patty Lees and Adam C. Lees, Magabala Books. The Trials of Portnoy, How Penguin Brought Down Australia's Censorship System by Patrick Mullins, Scribe Publications. And the winner is Kate Fulliger for The Warrior, The Voyager and The Artist, published by Yale University Press.
Well, as I always say, the State Library of New South Wales is my favourite library. Thank you again to the library for helping to recognise historians and to the judges who enable their vision. And congratulations to my fellow shortlisted authors. I hope this list reminds readers that there's a great array of non-fiction appearing in Australia at the moment. I've spoken about this book in several different forums over the past year, so I just want to reiterate here my thanks tonight to the army of scholars that helped me write it, both met and unmet. This book covered British history, Pacific history, and Cherokee history, so it depended on a larger than normal array of researchers. As a gesture of my regard, in particular to the Pacific and Cherokee researchers that went before me, I'd like to announce here that I will donate some of this prize money to two different scholarly organisations. The first is the Museum of the Cherokee Indian in North Carolina, which serves as a key research and public history institute for the Eastern Band of the Cherokee Nation. They know Ostinaco, the warrior, in my book very well, and I hope they believe that I have tried to further their aim in telling his extraordinary story to the world. The second organisation is quite different. It's housed in my own previous place of employment, Macquarie University. This is the Pacifica Student Association, which helps connect the amazing group of Pacifica students at Macquarie, many of whom I met during my last years there. I always wanted to offer more Pacific history at Macquarie, but it was not to be. So I hope these funds can help them further their own studies wherever they may lead, possibly to the Pacific itself. Once more, thank you to everyone involved in these awards. You do more good than you can imagine.
State Library is very grateful to the University of Technology, Sydney, for supporting the UTS Glenda Adams Award for New Writing. The judges for the fiction prizes this year were Stephanie Bishop, Angelo Lukakis, and Nicole Abadi. And the debut books they've chosen for this year's shortlist are The Octopus and I by Erin Hortle, Alan and Unwin, Cherry Beach by Laura McPhee Brown, Text Publishing, A Couple of Things Before the End by Sean O'Byrne, Black Ink, Song of the Crocodile by Nadi Simpson, Ashet Australia, The Inland Sea by Madeline Watts, One, an imprint of Pushkin Press, and the winning debut novel this year is Cherry Beach by Laura McPhee Brown, Text Publishing.
Hi, my name's Laura McPhee Brown. I'm the author of the novel Cherry Beach, which was published by Text Publishing in February last year. I'm overwhelmed and astonished by the fact that Cherry Beach has won the UTS Glenda Adams Award for New Writing. This means so much to me as a writer, and I just wanted to thank the judges, Stephanie, Nicole and Angelo. I'm so glad the book connected with you. To be on a shortlist with books written by Nadi, Erin, Madeline and Sean was already such an honour for me. So I just can't believe that I've actually won the prize. I wish that all the books could win the prize, but I'm so grateful. And I did want to say thank you to Text Publishing for being so supportive of my writing, for such a supportive publisher across last year, which was hard for all of us, and to my editor, David Winter, who the book wouldn't exist without him. He's really been very supportive and is just an absolutely wonderful editor. So thanks again, and congratulations to all the other winners. Thank you.
And now for the People's Choice Award. Each year we invite members of the public to nominate a favourite book from the shortlist of the Christina Stead Award for Fiction. And the works on the shortlist this year are A Room Made of Leaves by Kate Grenville, Text Publishing, Murmurations by Carol Lefebvre, Spinifex Press, Cherry Beach by Laura McPhee Brown, Text Publishing, The Dictionary of Lost Words by Pip Williams, Affirm Press, The Weekend by Charlotte Wood, Allen and Unwin, The Bass Rock by Evie Wilde, Penguin Random House Australia. And the winner of the People's Choice Award is The Dictionary of Lost Words by Pip Williams, Affirm Press.
It's been such an honour to have The Dictionary of Lost Words shortlisted for the Christina Stead Prize for Fiction, and so be one of those books that was eligible for the People's Choice Award. But to be the recipient of the People's Choice Award is really simply overwhelming. I've learned over the past 12 months how important fiction is when our reality is difficult or unpredictable. And I've turned to fiction myself over and over again to escape or seek comfort or be challenged. And every time I finish a satisfying book, I turn to the author page at the back and I offer up a silent message of thanks to the person who wrote it. So I'm incredibly moved to be the recipient of the People's Choice Award, because it means that The Dictionary of Lost Words has been one of those books that readers were able to escape into or seek comfort from or be challenged by during a year like no other, really. And I know I wouldn't be receiving this award tonight if it wasn't for the incredible support, the unfailing support of my publisher, Affirm Press, and also the Australian book industry in general. Booksellers, reading magazines, radio shows, podcasts, online book groups, they've all played a role in getting books into readers' hands during 2020. But it is the readers I'm most grateful to. You read my book, you recommended it, you bought it for friends and family as a gift. You spent time with me in the scriptorium, a garden shed in the back garden of James Murray's house in Oxford. You got to know Esme and you loved the book as much as I enjoyed writing it. And so thank you so much for the People's Choice Award. I'm incredibly grateful. This is absolutely something that I will remember for the rest of my life and think back on with such gratitude. Thank you.
And in 2021, the winner of the Christina Stead Prize for Fiction is Kate Grenville for A Room Made of Leaves, published by Text.
Hello. I'm absolutely thrilled to have won this award, thrilled and honoured, particularly because the shortlist is so very strong. I'd like to congratulate all my fellow shortlistees. And to say what I think we all know, which is that there is no best book in any given year, just a book that the judges had to, you know, they had to pick one. So I'm very appreciative of their work and also of the judges in picking me. So thank you. I want to express my appreciation for the descendants of John and Elizabeth MacArthur. who long ago deposited the MacArthur papers in the State Library so that anybody could access them. And I really appreciate that because it's an act of great generosity and public spiritedness to deposit those papers without without knowing how they might be used in the future. I've used those papers as the springboard for a work of fiction, but I couldn't have done it without those papers. And I also couldn't have done it without the archivists and the librarians at the State Library of New South Wales, who have, first of all, preserved those papers for many years, and also made them accessible to people like me, who otherwise wouldn't have a hope of finding a way in to that fabulously rich and interesting material. Most of all, though, I think I want to express my appreciation to Elizabeth MacArthur herself. I've written a work of fiction, but it was inspired by her life. And who knows what she was really like as a real person. But I can only say that whoever she was and however different she might have been from the fictional character that I created from her, whatever she was really like, she must have been a most remarkable woman. A most remarkable woman and a foremother who should be celebrated. So thank you again for this very great honour. I'm really, really grateful. Thanks.
Every year, the judges select a book of the year from the list of all the winners. And the book of the year, or rather its author, wins an additional $10,000 award. And I'm very pleased now to hand over to this year's senior judge, Jane McCready, to announce the book of the year.
Thank you, John. The judges of this year's New South Wales Premier's Literary Awards faced an extraordinary task. A record 633 entries were received in a dazzling array of genres and styles, with many works raising fundamental questions about authorship and who gets to tell the stories of our country. The six works nominated for Book of the Year stand out for the urgency of their themes and their exceptional literary skill, whether applied to the most intimate subject matter or larger global narratives. The nominees are The End of the World is Bigger Than Love by Davina Bell, The Warrior, the Voyager and the Artist by Kate Fulliger, A Room Made of Leaves by Kate Grenville, The Grandest Bookshop in the World by Amelia Mellor, Milk by Dylan Vandenberg, Throat by Ellen Van Nieuwen. And the winner of this year's Book of the Year is Ellen Van Nieuwen's fierce, passionate poetry collection, Throat.
Wow, I'm really stuck for words here. This is something that I never would have imagined. So thank you so much. And it gives me a boost to continue doing what I'm attempting to do, which is to write as gently and as considerately as possible. Keep doing that, and I hope you all have a wonderful night. Thank you.
And finally, I'd like to announce the winner of this year's special award. The special award is given for, if you like, a lifetime achievement of contribution to Australia's literary culture. Previous winners have included Thea Astley, David Williamson, Ruth Park, Thomas Keneally. And I'm delighted to announce that the winner of the special award in 2021 is Melina Marchetta. Melina has written 9 novels. Her most famous is probably Looking for Ali Brandy, which was originally published in 1993. Her novels have been published in 20 countries, and she's also a well-known screenwriter. Throughout her career, Melina's won numerous state premiers awards, including ours here in New South Wales. She's won a Prime Minister's Award, Children's Book Council of Australia Awards, Australian Film Industry Awards, and so it goes on. She was the recipient of the Prince Award for Young Adult Literature, run by the American Library Association. And she's always been very assiduous about contributing to the literary community in Australia as a teacher and through her support for emerging writers. She's an ambassador for Love Oz YA, which promotes Australian writers in the young adult genre. She's an ambassador for Room to Read, which is a not-for-profit organisation aimed at supporting children's literature and girls' education across Asia and Africa, and which is transforming the lives of millions of children in low-income countries by focusing on literacy and gender equality in education. Warmest congratulations to Melina Marchetta on this substantial achievement.
Hi, everyone. What a strange way to be doing this. But I just want to say that this is just so wonderful. I just want to thank the judges and the premier and anyone who put my name forward for this. To my publishers, Penguin Random House, who have been in my life, for the last 30 years, and I feel who have really nurtured me. I suppose the only, negative about this whole thing is I just would rather be in a room with you, because if there's something that really came through for me last year is just that pleasure of breaking bread with people and how much we missed it and how much storytelling takes place around a table. And I feel as if it's how storytelling came into my life, whether it was at my family table or with the extended family on a Sunday, there'd be about 30 of us and my grandfathers would be telling us stories and my great aunts, and they were stories of great journeys and hope and joy. And I think it's pretty obvious for anyone who's read any of my work or who know me that really has defined, those themes have defined my work for the past 30 years. It's not lost on me that such a wonderful tradition of oral storytelling, that I was born in a country where this oral storytelling is so important. It's been around for 40,000 years. And I feel so much pride in the fact that I wrote my first novel on Gadigal land. And I just want to pay my respects to the custodians of this land and to their leaders past and present. And I just want to say thank you to my family. They've kind of allowed me, actually I don't know whether they've allowed me, but I've done it anyway, steal the dialogue of our lives and write about, things that touch us, that have meant so much to us over the years. And I want to dedicate this to my daughter, who really comes from, both sides of a family, they're immigrants, and to remind her that they came here searching for something better, something safer, and that it is her place to invite or to welcome those who are searching for the same thing today. So thank you again. I kind of hope I get the opportunity one day to, do this in the real world. But I'm just very flattered that I've received this special award. Thank you.
Well, that brings this year's New South Wales Premier's Literary Awards to a close. I really hope this is the last time we have to do it like this. In 2022, very much looking forward to welcoming you all in person back to the State Library. Find it very hard just to talk to a camera in a corner of the room. I'd much rather talk to real people. But we really appreciate your support for the awards. We really appreciate your joining us this evening. We appreciate the support of all those who help make these awards what they are. The Premier, our Minister, Create New South Wales, UTS, Multicultural New South Wales, and the list goes on. Keep reading, keep writing, and I should add that this is also the beginning of the Sydney Writers' Festival, so I hope you go to as many events as you can, and I hope you really enjoy this year's festival. Good night, and thank you for joining us.